สวัสดีครับ Greetings from Bangkok from กสิทธิ์ พิรมยา once againThe recording of this particular tape has taken place or is taking place during the first week of April 2023 at the time when all political parties and their candidates go to the local district offices and so on around the country to register their candidatesSubmit application to become the candidates for the upcoming elections on the 17th of May next month, as well as to submit the list of the party list of about 100 names per political party to the registration office and so on. So in that sense, I think officially the political campaign has already begun. But evenmonths before that, during the course of last year to early this year and so on, many political parties, or practically every political party, has come out to offer a lot of populist policy measures projects, which I am very much against it because I see all the populism or populist policy measures as a short-lived, short gain. It doesn't benefit the country in the medium term and long term as a whole. It's more or less a political expediency type of measure in order to gain popular votes, some votes, you know, for the immediate political advantage, but not for the benefit of the country in terms of closing the development gap, closing the income gap,lessen poverty level and more turning the country into more just and fair and more distributive in order to, I think, raise the equality inside the Thai society, both from the people's point of view and second from the physical point of view of the so much of the discrepancy and the gap between the very modernized Bangkok, the capital city,and a lot of towns and villages around the country. The gap is too broad, too high. So there is a necessity for the leaders of all political parties and his and their respective parties and so on to come out to offer their vision for Thailand by stating what are the problems of Thai socio-economic scene and so on. What would be their vision?To raise the living standard, the social equality inside the Thai public. But so far, that has not been the case. And in that sense, to me, up to this very minute and second, I believe that there is a crisis of political leadership of Thailand for the fact that each of the political party leaders has not been able to come outto state their understanding of the shortcomings, the achievements, the potentials of Thailand. They have not been able to do so collectively. Second, if they do not know what is the situation in Thailand, then they will not be able to take Thailand out of all the shortcomings and predicaments and so on.And I have been repeating on and off again that Thailand is still in the middle income gap, lacking scientific know-how and technological advancement and so on. And we are too much dependent on the knowledge and on the research results and activities of foreign countries and so on. We are not, have not been able to be more independent on our own intellectual capacities and so on. And this is the work of all the political parties' leaders to come and tell the Thai public how they see the problems and the potentials and so on, and how they're going to present to us the policy measures to move Thailand forward. I will give them a few weeks. You know, for them to come out with a more solid policy direction for Thailand. And even after the elections on the 17th of May, I still will have the patience until the end of the year. Once all the political parties have their representatives inside the parliament, some would join the coalition government. But there will be the necessity of a continued positioning of the political parties in terms of their vision and understanding of Thailand and their information to provision of the information to the public of how they're going to move Thailand. It's a continuous process. It doesn't stop on the day after the elections. They still have to keep on talking to the public so that the public can render support, and at the same time the public will feel a bit better that their life and their predicaments and so on will definitely be overcome. Life would be improved, and that very much depends on the vision and knowledge of all the leaders of all the political parties of Thailand. And hopefully that before the 17th of May, something more solid and substantive could be offered to the people. If not, then I would continue to advise people or to answer questions from friends and so on and relatives, which party to choose. And I would say, I don't choose any party because I cannot accept any political party that has no knowledge about Thailand's position in the world, has no knowledge about the vision for Thailand to move up the ladder, to get out from this middle income trap or continuation of, I think, being a developing country and not to become a developed country in 5 to 10 years time. We have that potentials. But would the leaders of all the political parties have that vision to realize Thailand potentials and turn and transform Thailand from a developing country to a developed one in a few years time? The Chinese have shown us that they could do it. The Taiwanese have shown us that they have done it. And the mainland China is controlled by the Communist Party, a one-party system, but they achieve socio-economic development. The Republic of China in Taiwan has become a very modern, a very developed democratic society. So mainland China developed through the authoritarian route. The Republic of China in Taiwan developed through the capitalist, open democratic ways, multi-party system. So it doesn't matter which system you have, but the quality of the leadership is very important. And so far, Thailand has lacked and has failed in producing a quality leadership. But it's never too late. Each of the political party leader can review himself or herself and re-strategize his party and his vision for the future of Thailand. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ